First, we will go over how to access the free and reduced cost software portal. Visit the following link. Here you will need to click the link in the rightmost column to take you to the respective portal to access the software. It is important to note that each software has a different portal, so the process may differ between each link. Follow the instructions presented to you by the link, and you should be good to go. That is it. Now, if you're in the position where you need a device that is compatible with the software that does not operate on your device, please continue to the next section. Let us go over the Virtual Software Lab. To access the Virtual Software Lab, visit the following link. Here you have many options to choose from. Pick the one that best suits your needs. You can visit the And More link to see a full list of software that is offered in each specific virtual machine. In this example, I will be using the Graphics Lab selection. While we are here, it is important to note a couple of things. These machines are virtual. What that means for you is that when first accessing one of these computers, it will take a couple minutes to power on. If you're away from the virtual machine for too long once your session begins, your session may be ended. Do not worry, as you'll be notified if you are inactive too long. In the event that you are disconnected, you will be able to reconnect unless you are inactive for a long period of time. Once the machine has successfully booted, you will be presented with a computer running Windows. If this is your first time using this service, you may get a pop-up asking for permissions. Please allow them, as these permissions let your computer properly interface with the virtual computer. First, we will look at the navigation buttons on the top and see what they do. The first button will give you access to the File Explorer, Windows Native File Manager. The second will allow you to quickly switch between applications. The third will open a pop-up window where your session files are saved. While we are in this section, it is important to note that this should be treated like a computer from the computer lab or library. Your files will need to be saved prior to ending your session, otherwise they will be lost. Since there is no physical way to plug in an external storage device, you have the following option. Selecting the Add Storage option and signing in with your CPP account to sync your cloud storage with your virtual computer. The fourth button will allow you to copy and paste text from your personal device. The fifth button is for settings regarding your virtual session. Here you have access to enable microphone pass-through to the virtual computer, change the streaming settings to favor speed or visual quality, screen resolution, and regional settings if needed. The sixth button makes the virtual computer full screen. You can return the windowed view by pressing Escape on your keyboard or selecting the same button from the drop-down menu. Lastly for this section, the 7th button allows you to add multiple monitors to the virtual computer. These monitors will let you run full screen applications in a windowed pop-up. Finally, the last thing you need to know to get yourself up and running is where to access the programs you need. You can find all that installed software in the folder on your desktop. And that's it! We hope this quick overview is enough to get you up and running. Go Broncos!